1 year ago, 43 Mexican students were kidnapped and disappeared. To this day, there are still no answers for their families. On the 26th of September 2014, the group of student teachers went missing from Iguala in the southwestern state of Guerrero after they clashed with police. Since then, the families of the students have been left in an empty limbo, with fading hope and desperate for answers. Whilst their children are still missing, questions remain over the investigations by Mexican authorities. The Mexican government has said the students were rounded up by corrupt police who handed them over to a local gang before burning their bodies in a nearby dump. Parents and the public reacted angrily, rejecting the explanation, saying that without proof they would continue to believe their children were alive. Mexico's Attorney General said his team had interviewed 99 people, including members of the criminal gang whom he alleges murdered the students. The disappearance continues to pose problems for the country's president, Enrique Peña Nieto, who took office in 2012, vowing to stamp out years of drug-related violence. He has been criticised for his handling of the crisis and accused of trying to wrap up the case without a proper investigation. This video, reportedly taken on the night the students went missing, shows a van sprayed with bullets at one point where the students were attacked. A victim can be seen lying on the ground, although it's not clear whether the body belongs to one of the missing students. The tragic incident has sent shockwaves across Mexico. Relatives of missing students have held a number of protests and marches over the course of the last year. In November 2014, demonstrators set fire to the local legislature building in Guerrero's capital in protest. Members of a teachers' union set fire to the session hall in the state assembly building and several cars outside. In October this year, Peña Nieto vowed to hunt down those involved in the apparent massacre.
This is an event which cannot go unpunished. In a few words, there should not be, as I pointed out, the smallest crack of impunity. We have to go deep and get to the bottom of this to find those responsible, those who, by negligence or action, allowed or covered up this event so that it was able to happen in Iguala.
In November 2014, the government said it found the charred remains of dozens of bodies in a garbage dump and in a river, and that three men detained in the case admitted setting fire to the victims. The Attorney General then confirmed investigators had established that the bodies of the murdered students were incinerated at a rubbish tip by members of the Guerreros Unidos drug gang. It is alleged they thought the students were part of an attempt to take over their territory by another local group backed by corrupt local authorities. A team of international experts said this month all does not add up, citing deep flaws in the government's investigation and dismissing its claims that the victims were incinerated in a garbage dump. A report conducted by respected investigators from Chile, Colombia, Guatemala and Spain is said to blast holes in the Mexican government's claim that the student bodies were burned.
It's a very dry dump and therefore a forest fire would have had to have been generated, a fire that would have burnt the whole area. For all those reasons, we have reached the conclusion the youngsters were not burnt at the Cocula rubbish dump.
The parents of the victims have cheered the report and vowed not to let up on the government until their children are found.